In this interactive simulation, we're showing a plot of pressure versus enthalpy for water and showing the two-phase region as well as compressed liquid and superheated vapor. The idea is to get a better understanding of what this diagram represents, because if we look at this diagram in a book, it looks something like I'm showing you here, except that it's black and white and we have all these crisscrossing lines, and it's very difficult to understand the behavior from that type of diagram. So what the simulation does is allow you to select, by checking these boxes, which of these lines are actually displayed, and therefore to get a much better understanding of what the behavior is. And so right now they're all selected, but they're at least in color to make it a little easier to see. We've labeled the saturated liquid line, the saturated vapor line, and the critical point and the critical isotherm. Let's now look at the actual simulation, observe what the various lines correspond to. So here's the interactive simulation, and I've started out the black and white display. This is how you would typically see it in a book, and it makes it very difficult to understand what's being shown. So first, let's shift over to color. All the curves of the same behavior, all the entropy curves, for example, are one color. And now I'm going to remove the grid lines to make it less cluttered, and let's just keep the temperature lines initially. And so the idea is, if we just display the temperature lines, we can much more easily see the behavior. Of course, this is the phase envelope, and if I select critical, it's going to display the critical isotherm, purple line, and it's also going to label the saturated liquid and the saturated vapor lines. If we use this diagram and now we start adding in, for example, entropy, now it's a little easier to follow if we're just looking at entropy, and constant entropy curves are now shown with their numerical values represented here in kilojoules per kilogram per Kelvin. Now I could add in vapor quality and let me remove entropy. And so I can see the different values corresponding to different qualities, different fractions of vapor present. And I can also remove vapor quality and instead add in density lines, and I could remove temperature to make those density lines even easier to see. I can remove the critical. Now we have constant density curves on the pressure enthalpy diagram. So the purpose here is to make it a little easier to understand and read values off a graph like this online or in a textbook.